The New York Times issued an investigation into Donald Trump and his family's tax evasion practices. And there were some cases that appeared to be fraud, fraudulent behavior in order to pay as little in taxes as possible following the passing of Fred Trump. And as a result, instead of paying a 55% tax rate on the money and the property that Trump and his siblings had inherited, they only paid 5%. And they did so by severely undervaluing the property that they inherited, and they did that through fraudulent appraisals. And then the second thing that we unfortunately didn't get a chance to talk about yesterday had to do with a sham corporation that they created that would invoice Fred Trump for certain products that were needed to upgrade or update his properties. And what they would do, and keep in mind, this sham corporation was run by Fred Trump's nephew, and he was the one who would send these invoices that had massive markups. So like, let's say for an air conditioner, there would be massive markups, and when Fred Trump would pay the sham company for the products, Trump and his siblings would pocket the difference in money.
So there was, and we talked a lot about several different scams that they ran that the New York Times exposed yesterday. Anna's referring to another one here. But one of them was that they lowered the value of their father's real estate holdings so they could pay less estate tax and less gift tax and less tax overall. And there was a number of different scams. But in this one particular one, they lowered it to his holdings to $41.4 million. Okay. Over the next decade, they sold the property in reality for 16 times that value. So you get a sense of that's why they're saying that this is very likely fraud. Because you know, you claim for tax purposes that something's worth, let's say your house, right? You say, oh, my house is only worth $100,000 because I don't want to pay too much property tax. Then you turn around 2 years later and sell the house for $1.6 million. Well, that was a scam.
Yeah,
right?
And by the way,
you're not allowed to do that because there's this appraisers, et cetera. But in this case, they write down on a piece of paper, yeah, this is what my holdings are. Mm-hmm. And the way that this works is if the IRS or whoever else catches you later, that's how you're find out. Like, there's different ways that the government tracks different properties, but in these cases, you literally self-report, and if they never catch you, you get away with it. Which, by the way, is the story of Donald Trump's life.
Absolutely.
He did all these criminal things over and over again, fraud, lying over and over again, and he never got caught. So he thought, I'm never gonna get caught. So
he got caught with Trump University. I mean, he got caught sometimes, but when it came to big things like this, he did not get caught. Now, he saved hundreds of millions of dollars in taxes as a result of his fraudulent behavior, okay? And the other part of this story, the part that Trump seems to care about way more, is the way that it makes him look. Because something that he repeats over and over again is that he is a self-made billionaire, and that he only received a one-time small $1 million loan that he then paid back in interest, paid back his father in interest. But the findings in this New York Times investigation shows he received a lot more money from Fred Trump. In fact, let's go to graphic 21. Trump received at least $413 million in today's dollars from his father's real estate empire. By the way, starting at age 3. And the reason why that happened wasn't because, you know, his father was like, oh, I have a 3-year-old, I gotta start giving him money. His father was trying to find ways to essentially use his children as his employees. He's paying them money. You know, like, it was a way of also saving at that time and also dispersing the money in such a way that he would save taxes in the future.
So look, there's several different scams running at the same time. So let me just quickly try to break down that particular one, why he starts transferring the money to his kids. Because he doesn't want to pay the estate tax. That's one of the reasons why. Mm-hmm. And the estate tax is 55% at the time. So, and by the way, you are allowed to give your kids a certain amount of money every year. You're allowed to give anybody $10,000 and nobody gets taxed on that. But if you give more than $10,000, and that's why, by the way, Fred Trump at every Christmas would give Donald Trump a $10,000 check. And
wait,
Trump
says
he's a self-made man. Yeah, so by the way, that's the smallest amount that Trump ever got from his dad.
Really quick, so I didn't even know that. So if someone gifts you $10,000, you don't have to pay taxes on it?
You don't have to pay taxes on it. But if you go above $10,000, you got to pay taxes on it. So that's why he starts to funnel the money to his kids as soon as they're born. At that point, Donald Trump hasn't done anything wrong. He's 3 years old. It's Fred Trump who's trying to evade taxes, okay? So, but he keeps giving him more and more money. So by the time he gets around college, he's getting $1 million a year from his dad. So that lie about, oh, I only got $1 million loan, preposterous. He got money funneled to him in 1,000 different ways. There's the Christmas checks, there's $1 million a year. By the time he's in his 40s and 50s, his dad's still giving him money, now up to $5 million a year. Okay, now I haven't gotten to the loans yet. The loans are a different category. The loans, he keeps giving him over and over and over again, and Trump never pays him back. And that's again why he thinks, oh, I can just go bankrupt. I get loans, I never give them back. That's how loans work. And that's why when he first came into office, he scared even his own advisors because he said, why don't we just not pay the deficit back, the debt back? They're like, no, this is the US government. It's not a small business. You can't do that. That would crater the entire global economy. But this guy is a loser, a total loser who's milked his dad all this time. And his dad, of course, was happy to do it, aided and abetted. Well, I'm not sure his dad was happy with what happened at the very end, though. So first of all, Trump then turned around and pretended his dad gave him nothing.
Yeah.
That he paid back the $1 million loan. Oh, by the way, did I tell you the amount of loans he got was over $60 million? And so he got $60 million in loans. And by the way, and if they did it on purpose and they did it in coordination, which is not yet clear, that's also illegal. You can't just give someone a loan and they don't pay you back. No, that's giving him the money. You should pay taxes on that, right? Mm-hmm. So that's another scam. But he gets $60 million from him on that. He gets $413 million just given to him. And the last one, by the way, was when in the estate, he got $177.3 million when his dad died, which in today's money is $236 million. This guy's the temerity to say my dad didn't do anything for me. He just gave me a small $1 million loan. His dad's a bad guy too, but at least he's smart. He worked hard, etc. And it bothers me to my core that he puts his dad down like that after he got everything from his dad.
Yeah, exactly. Right? Because he wants to appear like he's smart, that he's a savvy businessman. The one thing that Trump is good at is marketing. And so that's what he wanted out there. He wanted everyone to think that he's a smart, savvy businessman. When in reality, as we've said several times on the show, he's gone bankrupt 6 times. And a smart, savvy businessman wouldn't go bankrupt 6 times. A smart, savvy businessman wouldn't get denied loans in the United States and then have to go to places like Russia to get loans. That's exactly what happened to Donald Trump.
So last two things, we've got to tell you about this because this is a super important story. And it's being buried by all the other gigantic news events going on. So near the end, Donald Trump tried to get all of his dad's money, okay? Mm-hmm. And tried to even screw over his own siblings. Of course he did, because he has no empathy for anybody, right? And he didn't succeed in that. But at the end, the estate's already been given away to all the kids through all these scams, right? So one of the last things left in the estate was a $10.3 million IOU to Fred Trump from Donald Trump.
Oh my God.
So it's like Al Capone's vault when Geraldo looked at. There's nothing left inside, just a big IOU from Donald Trump. Ha ha, the money, I'm never gonna pay you back, Dad. And then after you die, I'm gonna lie about you all the time and say you were this two-bit businessman. It turns out he actually had $1 billion, his dad did, okay? And I'm gonna pretend I did it all and you did nothing. That's who Donald Trump is, but this last part is the most important. Well, criminal liability has run out already. You can't prosecute him on the statute of limitations has run out. But the New York State Department of Taxation and Finance is now, quote, reviewing the allegations of the New York Times article and is vigorously pursuing all appropriate avenues of investigation. He has not escaped civil liability. They can go back and say, hey, we didn't catch you at the time when you ran the scam, but according to the law, we can catch you at any time. And they have 200 tax returns from Fred Trump that the New York Times found. Turn it over to investigators, and the fines could be monstrous.
Can't wait.
Can't wait. And as you can see, this guy's a buffoon. He probably has very little money left.
And remember, he's already being investigated by prosecutors in New York because of his charitable foundation, which he's used to enrich himself. And he's taken money out of that for his own settlements.
Unfortunately, if the civil fines come and they are as big as they in this case, it looks like they evaded hundreds of millions of dollars in taxes. The American taxpayer or the New York taxpayer might have, at the end, just a big IOU from Donald Trump, because he doesn't even have that kind of money, because he's an idiot who milked off his dad his whole life. He's a sad little baby. The TYT Plus app is now available on iOS and Android. Download to get more TYT content at tyt.com/app.